For over 100 years, the Hudson's Building has dominated the landscape of downtown Detroit. Filled with memories of a former city, the building, whether demolished or developed, defines not only who we were, but who we are about to become.
Hudson's in particular is known, if you talk about food service, the chicken pot pie and the Maurice salad, I think they're the famous things.
Well, the elevator operators and starters were some of the best. They were some of the best. They spread so much goodwill and courtesy throughout the company. And I am just proud of them to this day.
We always went to the toy store on the 12th floor before Christmas, which was a wonderful experience, and saw Santa Claus.
Time to move and to act one way or the other. And in the absence of a financially feasible plan, then I think you take the building down.
To me, the way I look at it is how much greater a victory it would be to redevelop the building rather than to destroy it. To me, destroying it is just trying to erase a bad memory, and it's not a victory at all.
This is a defining moment for the people of the city of Detroit and for this council and this administration.
On October 24th, 1998, after several previously announced dates had come and gone, the big store was prepped for demolition. Using 2,728 pounds of explosives, placed in 1,100 locations, Controlled Demolitions Incorporated set two world records for both the tallest and largest single building ever to be imploded. The People Mover, as predicted, sustained considerable damage, resulting in losses for area businesses. It was reopened 3 months later on a reduced basis. The dust cloud from the 660 million pounds of rubble swallowed the city, and concerns arose regarding its contents. Though tests did find elevated levels of asbestos and lead, they were within acceptable state guidelines.